Hi, welcome to segment two here, and we're going to continue, and in fact, actually begin, on the things that's going to help you to compete in the real world of bass. The thing that I guess separates the men from the boys from, let's say, the people that are doing studio jobs, doing the so-called, quote-unquote, prestigious live gigs, all that sort of thing, and someone who really wants to get into that arena, that professional arena, it's not a chop situation. So many incredible videos that you can find on the web that will talk about licks, we'll talk about playing fast, all of these types of things. And that's an artistic statement, and it certainly deserves respect, and I give that respect here. But we're talking about the aspect of time and groove. And as I had talked about originally in the first segment, being able to play in time is going to be like money in the bank, but it is also a way to really project your ideas. I can't emphasize enough how important it is to play in time. If you don't play in time, it's kind of like putting together a disjointed sentence. And again, the idea of playing in time is not that hard if you do it correctly. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to put this bass down on my lap just for a second. I'm not going to play for a minute or so. But I'm going to introduce you to my little friend here, Metronome. This is a very old metronome, by the way, and they probably make much more advanced models. This one is a Dr. Beat, a Boss Dr. Beat DB66, who a good friend who keeps up with those things told me that they're no longer producing these. So what you want to go for, and this is something that is really important, I want to really drive home to you how important this is to get a metronome with a nice wooden tock, not the beep, beep, beep. That is really annoying, and it's disconcerting, and you're absolutely going to hate using a metronome. I'm at 98 beats per minute, and here's the sound. You see what I'm talking about? You're not necessarily getting a metallic or a definable tone clip, and you do not want that. You also want one that subdivides. Right now, this is beating on quarter notes. And see, this is what bums people out. This is the number one complaint I get from people over the years that have talked about, man, I don't want to use a metronome. This stuff is just mechanical. It doesn't do anything. Well, the idea is not playing quarter notes of what you're hearing now. Check this out. And you tap your foot along with it, of course. This is simple to understand but harder to grasp, so hang with me here. Again, we're on quarter notes. One, two, three, four, one, two, three, four, etc., so on. What this does, aside from creating insane boredom and stifling any kind of creativity or any way to help your playing, is that you're just hearing naked quarter notes. It's just a continuous stream. It's mechanical, right? So what I'm going to do is have the click go on two and four. Huh? Okay. Hang with me. Four, one, two, three, four, one, two, three, four. Drummer snare. Bat, dum, dum, bat, boom, boom, bat, boom, boom. You with me? Dum, bat, boom. Again. Four, one, two, three, four. Bat, dum, bat, 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 bat. See what I'm talking about? Now, if you just basically, this is nothing technical at all, because we're talking again, and that's my main theme. Again, we're talking about these basic ideas that you must work on every day. Again, this is a conditioning thing. It's not good enough to just do this right one time, and that makes you a better player. I'm sorry, there's no shortcuts. This is still a world that rewards hard work, and you don't have to do this 8 hours a day, but it's something that you need to do consistently. Again, repetition is the mother of skill. So here we have we're back to the just straight quarter note thing, and we're just going to play like an eighth note groove. With me? One, two, three, four, one, two, three, four, one, two. Okay. Here's the challenge, if you will. Now, the metronome is beating on two and four, and this will take you a few go-rounds to get this, but this is really important to do. again, the metronome is beating on 2 and 4. Well, how do you grasp that? How do you encapsulate that into the bar? Well, you feel the groove. You're beating quarter notes with your foot. 1, 2, with me? And verbalize, and this is very important, by the way, and you'll see in subsequent videos, it's important to verbalize what you're doing, and it really links up your left and right brain. So, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. See what I did there? I felt the continuum of the groove. I found a click and called it 4. It'll take a couple of bars for it to feel normal, but check it out. 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, and. Like a drummer's snare. Now, does that feel a little more natural? That's what a bass player listens anyway to a drummer, is the 2 and 4. And after a while, you won't think 2 and 4. You'll just think of a drummer snare. This will bring in a lot of naturalness to what you're doing. Now, why would you do that? I use a concept that I didn't invent, but I remember reading it one time in a book. It's called The Power of Why. Or it's either a chapter or some sort of a thing that I'd read. Why would you do something like that? Well, here is the big thing why, again, as I illustrated, why bass players will not use a metronome correctly. Notice when you're playing, when you had the metronome on 2 and 4, we're going to go down to the 2 and 4 again. 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. What that does, it centers you into you playing the downbeat. If there's anything that's a hireable skill, in other words, people will pay you money for your skill, is being able to lay a note in on the downbeat. And if you don't condition yourself to do that, it's not going to happen groove-wise. It's a very simple concept, but it's something you should keep on all the time of doing. You notice I removed the downbeat. It's the bass player's responsibility. You might remember in the first segment I was talking about how the bass player commits to the note first. And you're going to do that with the metronome on 2 and 4. See, it swings, and when you can make the metronome disappear, and it's not a mechanical thing, and you can play your favorite tunes or whatever. This, think of a drummer's snare. Don't you do that anyway when you play? And this is what I'm talking about. We practice and work on the things that we're going to be using on the gig. Does that make sense? Power of why? Questions? Okay. Now, here's something that I want to talk about. Is the aspect of playing, how do you use a metronome? And this will probably be the only time in this video series you'll see me do this, but maybe you'll catch me in using it at another time. But I'm going to play a major scale, and we're going to talk about using this metronome, and there it is again, beating on 2 and 4, and we'll grasp that in a second. And here's our old favorite, a G major scale, and a little out of time, but we're just playing the notes. Right. Now, here's a big one, is the long notes. Now, why would you play long notes? I'll turn this off just for a second. Why would you play long notes? Because a lot of players, when they sit down, and they'll either see their favorite player or think it makes you a better player if you're playing really fast. And that's not necessarily true. You're talking about addressing the groove first. Man, if you can play the groove and understand the chord and make people sound better, man, the band will follow you off a cliff. And you'll see what I mean as we get into this a little more. But if you practice your notes long, now why would I say that? Long note, right? Too many people, when they're playing, will play very disjointedly and trying to get that funk thing going on, which is great. See what I'm talking about? But those are short notes. If you play your notes long, check this out. This is what I'm going, this is the whole thing. Long note. To shorten the note, all you have to do is maintain flesh contact with the string. Check it out. Let up on the string. I stopped it, didn't I? But if I practice all of my stuff disjointed and short notes, that's how my playing is going to sound, and you're not going to work on a ballad. In fact, it won't be really good musicianship. And it flummoxes a lot of players, and it's a shame. If you practice your notes long, and again, you're listening, again, to shorten the note, yeah, left hand muting, all you're doing, maintaining flesh contact with the string and letting up. If you practice your stuff in a disjointed way, all your notes are going to sound short. What are you going to do when you have to play a whole note on a tune and really make it groove? It's gotten to the point that this will sound trippy, but I can actually tell whether a bass player is experienced or not if they're playing one note. Within a band, anybody can play one note. But I'm talking about putting that note in the context of the groove. Big fat note, and it makes everybody sound good, and it provides propulsion. The secret of that is to practice your notes long. So, first time around, we'll do this with just the naked quarter notes, the boring way, as I call it. One, two, three, four. Descending. Now, after 5 minutes of that, I'm sure you'd want to have a stiff drink or go to bed or something or watch TV. But it becomes a little bit more your responsibility to play the groove if you're on 2 and 4. So, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Drummer snare. That. See when that one note begins? The other one ends. Now, if a dude is practicing the notes long, he's able to do that and control. You only do that when playing long. Again, all I'm doing is playing the note, releasing. Very, very important concept. The length and the placement of the notes and the muting of the left hand. Very basic skill, but after you've watched this video, I would invite you to try this concept, and I'll show you later on what to practice to make this a little bit more creative. But as long as you hear the difference, and always remember, encourage yourself. There's something within you that you can bring out that's very unique to you. Very, very important to do this. And I'll see you on the next segment.